Alright, Stop Mo Production Diary number 27. Hey everybody. Just getting out here to start filming. It's a little chilly, more chilly today. I haven't had much of a chance to use my heater, honestly. I'm going to fire it up today, just kind of take the edge off the shed while I get my stuff out here. I've been doing that lately, just kind of turned on for a little bit. It's, you know, it runs on kerosene. Which is supposed to be clean burning, and you can actually supposed, you know, in theory, use this thing in your living room. I usually leave the door kind of cracked because it just worries me a little bit, you know. Such a confined space, I'd hate to poison myself out here. And then when I actually start animating, I just kick it off and shut the door up. And but it definitely heats this place up pretty fast. It's kind of cool. You don't even need a match to light it. It's got this little door here. And then in there's where it burns. I don't know if you guys can see. You just push this little knob down, and that little glow rod comes down. It lights that wick. There's kind of like this huge wick that goes all the way around that thing. As you can see, that's what it looks like inside. And you got a knob here that just adjusts that thing down or up. And they say to kind of get it right about there. Not any bigger. It'll start smoking and stuff. And then I think there's like some kind of emergency shutoff too, where if the thing would actually say fall over or something, it would go off. But it's a neat little heater. I mean, it definitely kicks the heat out. If I had like a shop like twice this big, or maybe even like three times as big, it's like this thing would totally heat it. And I don't know. It was a good investment. That's where everything's at. I got some dust on the floor from where I was drilling tie downs. Everything's been in suspended animation for about 4 days. So I had Thanksgiving, and then my dad wanted to build this shed, so me and my brother went out and helped him frame up this shed. And you know, it's just the holiday season takes up your time. But I'm going to try to actually get this, hopefully finish this shot today. I'd really like to finish it and just kind of see if I got to reshoot it, which I'm, you know, might be a possibility. Or if I can just go on and shoot the rest of these little shots in here, which would be cool. I don't know if you guys can see what I'm doing, but how I've been getting the fishing line through his costume when I need to kind of reposition it. So I'm using a needle, and I just thread the fishing line through it, and then go right through his costume right there, and then tie a knot. That seems to be holding. Notice it's actually been really tough to film in here because it's so dark, and I'm having a hard time getting the camera up where I need it so you guys can see what the hell's going on, you know. So anyway, I think once I get past this little section and the puppet's a touch more stable, I can show you guys more what I'm doing. So I finally figured out how to do some filming in here. Is this moving? I've been having a hard time getting any kind of footage of me animating, and that's because my camera's too low. Hopefully you guys can see me. But I found this stick that I used to stick my webcam on for the ArtCast, and I was like, I'm going to put the camera on there and bring it out, and actually I think it's pretty good. You guys can kind of see what's going on finally. So one of the problems I'm actually having is, as you can see, I've got a tie down right here to this foot. He's kind of back sliding a little bit, so that's why I don't even have a nut on this, because I'm just kind of pushing him back. But this foot has just turned into a real pain. It's actually, the tie down is not wanting to hold. I can't get it down tight. When I tighten it down, it actually, you can feel it pop, and then you tighten it down again, you feel it pop, and you can actually just work the whole screw out. So that's turned into a real problem. I'm just trying to finish up this shot. And what I realize is, since I made the toes out of little pieces of aluminum, that aluminum is just not strong enough to, you know, be able to tighten down the tie down like over and over and over again. You know, it's like strong enough to hold for like quite a while, like it's been doing, but it's just not being strong enough to hold consistently over time. So I think what I'm going to do is when I finish the shot, if I get it done, I'm going to go back and drill out the feet, and I'm going to stick some like a nut in there and epoxy it in there so that I have like a piece of steel that I'm screwing into, and hopefully that'll work. But I don't know if I'll get to that this week. Right now I'm just trying to get this done. It's so hard for me to see if you guys can see the frame grabber, but that's kind of what I've been working on. He's going backwards there, but see, he kind of gets up, slides back a couple times. I'm having some fun with that. And the camera is raising, and I can't tell if it's going to be smooth yet or not. But the preview, you know, they're not previewing like full frames and stuff, so it's a lot more jittery and quick, I noticed, than what it actually is when you put it in the editing program. But I think it's coming out okay. I love this feature on Dragon. If you can see that little red dot down there, that's the onion skinning. So like right now it's off. Where's the camera at? So then we get to the last frame. So there's the last frame. You can see my hand in there like that. Then when you turn on the onion skinning, see how it blends the last frame and the new frame, and my hand looks kind of invisible. And it's just awesome because you can sit here and, you know, move on the puppet and really like refine your moves. Like look back at the screen, kind of make sure that things are moving the way it's supposed to move and all that. You know, it's kind of weird, like when you start to animate and you start to see it working on the frame grabber. I remember this like with the shot where the guard walks around and peeks around the corner, because that was a shot I had in my mind for like years, really. Like ever since I first started this idea, I always had that shot of him looking around, the guard looking up, and then him popping back around the corner. And when you finally see it like happening, and it's super weird because it's like something that you just imagined, you know? And I know I do that with my art and like stuff like that, where I draw something out and like you draw out what you imagine. But there's something else where it's like when it's moving, I mean, you put the music with it and you got the sound effects, it's just like you sort of made it real or something. It's wild, you know? I mean, it's one cool thing about animation that I don't really feel when I'm even doing comics and stuff like that. So he's kind of sliding back at this point. And he's just kind of crunching down in there. And see, then I can check my shot, like right here, and just see, I got the camera in front of there. That's what that thing that pops in is. That's actually the camera. Just see what I mean, like right between those two shots is what I just did. All right, so I just took that shot. Now I just want him to not really move at all. I just want him to, it almost to be a stop kind of a thing. Just like scarf kind of straightens out. Because what happened was he slid down, and now he's like stopping right there. So I kind of want a second of sort of non-movement, and he kind of starts to go back up. See, this is the frame I'm shooting right here. And not much happens except for his arm a little bit, and then his scarf kind of drops down a little bit. And I'm going to bring his arm up just a smidge, kind of put it back where it was. Like he's kind of gripping. That looks pretty good. The second thing I do on each shot is I'm slowly moving the camera up this line. And each time I move it, as you can see, I kind of make a mark just in case it would fall back down, or I push it down, I know where it's at. And I draw a little mark and I push the camera up a little bit. Here it is right at the end. As you can see, that move, that camera move, like right there is a camera move. You can just barely see it. It's barely raising. If you kind of run the whole thing, you can see it moving up. So it's just like really slight at this point. And then I kind of lean back and reach over there very carefully and hit the enter. And then Dragon makes that camera sound, and then also my camera makes a sound. And then I move to the next shot. And also while I'm doing this whole thing, I'm actually marking my X sheets, as you can see. As I go down, I write the frame number, and then I mark the action, which is over here, and the camera move, which is kind of over here. I know that's kind of blown out, but... And each time I do an action, like he's going to do like another... He's going to kind of start to step back up and try to get up, and he might slide one more time, I'm not sure. And each time he like steps up, I just start to think, how long does that take? So like a step. So it's not quite a second. You know, I just kind of count it, like 1,000. I could have like a stopwatch, that'd be a better way to do it. But that kind of makes me think about how many moves should be in that step. And over here on the X sheet, if you guys can see, because I have the seconds, like his next step should come to about here, which is about like 8 frames down. And that's sort of how I'm trying to keep my timing.
So the next move is he's going to start going back up. So I'm just going to push from right here and actually hold his foot down, because I want him to kind of use his muscles like as if he was really going forward. All right, so I'm going to check the frame grabber. And that works pretty good. He moves a little bit forward, but he kind of came up a little bit when I pushed him, so I'm actually going to lower him because I want him to be kind of more of a forward push kind of a thing. Like that. And the other thing I want to do is I want his arms to be kind of appearing to hang on, even though they kind of look out probably from you guys. From this angle, it looks like his hands are on it. So I'm going to want to push this hand back to kind of down to where it was, which is right there. And then the backhand, let me see. So backhand definitely moved forward. Get a hold of this guy. Bring that back just a smidge. I actually had a spot burn out right there. Not the one that's shining, of course, but there's one right beside it. Right there. And I don't know, as I flip through the frames, I can't tell if there's a big lighting shift, but you know, when you're looking at these live frames, that's sort of, you know, they're not as good, they're not as high res as like the finished ones you'll be using in After Effects. So I'm just gonna keep going and get the shot done, but that's kind of a bummer. I haven't had one of those burn out yet. That's too bad. It burned out right in the middle of a shot, so maybe my flashlight idea wasn't as good as I thought it was. You know, like just thinking about that though, I wonder if there is actually like a good alternative to small spotlights like that, that, you know, I could just pull out of a lamp or something that would have like, you know, just LED bulbs in them. I'm just sitting there like thinking to myself, because you do see small kitchen lights and stuff that have those small kind of spotlight bulbs. That might be another thing I could mess around with and try to figure out. But the small spotlights though, I mean, they just seem to be like the perfect thing to light like the small characters, especially for like the rim lights and you know, kind of backlighting something and things like that. Because I noticed like with the bigger bulbs, like the bigger LED bulbs, they were great for like casting like, you know, light across like the rocks and, you know, sort of giving an ambient light and all that kind of stuff. But to really give like those hard defining lights on the edges of the characters, you need like something shooting at it, kind of like a flashlight. Something I'm gonna have to experiment with as, you know, the project goes on. So it's Thursday already, so I've got time to make the video. So I didn't get that much animation done this week, but we'll see how far I get today. I was looking around my studio and I found this bulb actually. I was talking about, you know, just trying to find some kind of LED lights for a, you know, something like a kitchen light or something like this. It's got a normal, you know, receptacle, so you can just screw it in. So I could just get some can lights and screw this in. And I was testing it out just on my table. I'm not going to switch any lights now, of course, but it's more of a directional light. And I put a little, you know, piece of paper around it to check and see if I could make it into a pretty, you know, tight spot. I actually could do that pretty easy. So maybe this is the answer. I've been trying to read what it is on here, but it's so shiny I can't quite see it. So I finally got him off that rafter and he's perched up there. I think I'm going to wrap it up for this week, guys. Thanks a lot for watching. Check me out on Patreon if you want to help me, you know, support this project and all my videos. See you Monday for the Artcast, and see you next week for the next stop motion video.